The holy grail of aiming is having aim that feels instinctive, where you can get your crosshair to move exactly where you intend it to. To achieve this, we need to perfect the interface between our own body, the mouse, and what happens on screen. An incredibly important, yet almost entirely undiscovered variable is optimizing your mouse sensor's orientation. My setup provides an excellent example. With large hands, a claw-style grip that I've covered in a previous video linked in the description, and using the uniquely shaped G303 Shroud Edition, my mouse sensor points off in this direction rather than being more in line with my hand. As a result, look at what happens when I aim left to right in paint without fixing it. When aiming left to right, you would expect the lines to be horizontal, but in my case, they're significantly skewed. This shows me there's a disconnect between where I intend to aim and what actually happens on screen. You can try this yourself too, but there are a few things to be aware of when doing it that I'll cover in just a moment. Now, this doesn't mean that if I were to try and track something in game, that my aim would follow that same skew. Our brains are remarkably good at compensating for this discrepancy. But despite this, one of the problems is that our hand is now at a mechanical disadvantage. The vast majority of all aiming is done horizontally, so we want the most comfortable and accessible range of motion in our hand to cover this area. For me to aim to the left, I have to pinch in my wrist and also pull down somewhat, instead of just naturally moving to the left, and the opposite happens when aiming to the right. The second problem is that we're essentially wasting energy aiming through a filter to correct this discrepancy, instead of having one-to-one raw input from our hand to the crosshair on screen. The good news is that there's an easy way to solve this problem. So let's take a look at how to determine if there's anything for you to fix, and if so, how you do it. Firstly, grip your mouse as if you were actively aiming at something and take a look at the other side. Does the mouse sensor line up with your hand, or does it flare out to one side? If there's no obvious skew, there may be nothing to fix here, but if there is, you can have the perfect mouse sensor orientation while also keeping your favorite mouse grip. Something important to note before we dive in here is that our range of motion isn't equally split left to right. With my wrist in a neutral position, this is how far I can aim to the left, and here is how far I can aim to the right. You can see there's about 30% less range of motion to the right side. So now when we open up paint, grip your mouse as if you were aiming, plant your wrist to one spot, and aim left to right with that comfortable range of motion. You may need to lower your mouse DPI to keep everything in the window, and be sure not to fall into the trap of finding the perfect balance around neutral, because we don't actually aim like that in game. The goal here isn't to force yourself to draw straight lines, but instead to use your wrist's natural range of motion, rather than any compensations you may have adapted to using, like the wrist pinch sensation I mentioned earlier. And for the record, I do not recommend planting your wrist when actually aiming, but it is useful to get consistent results with this testing. You can also try this with your eyes closed, or looking at your hand instead of the screen, if you think you may be automatically adjusting your lines. Try this a few times to see what sort of angles you are drawing. And now for the fun part, how to fix any discrepancies and find your perfect mouse sensor orientation. To do this, we'll need to download Raw Excel, which is the same tool used by aimers that use mouse acceleration. It's fully signed with a 1 second delay on write, so it cannot be used to cheat, and it is currently considered safe by anti-cheat programs. The link is down below. If you have other concerns or questions about it, I've linked to the FAQ in the description and their Discord. After installing it and restarting your PC, open it up. We don't need to worry about the mouse acceleration at all for this. We only care about this wonderful rotation field. To get a feel for how it works, try something drastic like 20, which you will find exaggerates the problem, and minus 20 that will cause the same trouble just in the opposite direction. Finding the rotation that works best for you will likely take some iteration over time as you get more comfortable with the new range of motion now available to you. That being said, we can get pretty close on the first time with the following test. Set the rotation to minus 15, grip as if you're aiming, and draw left to right with that comfortable wrist range of motion. It may help to imagine you're tracking a target that is strafing. and remember not to force yourself to draw straight lines. And you'll probably see that the right side is now angled up, so next, set it to 0 and do the same. For me, the right side is angled down, so that tells me my rotation lies somewhere between 0 and minus 15. Next, try minus 14, then minus 1, then minus 13, then minus 2, and so on, until you find what number gets you closest to horizontal. If the end result is slightly off, feel free to experiment with decimals to find that sweet spot. I personally find minus 9.5 to work best for me, but my skew is quite significant. Some may find great benefits from only small adjustments, like minus 2. When I first used this tool, I ended up at minus 6.3, but after getting used to how the correction feels, minus 9.5 to minus 10 has consistently given me the flattest lines and the best performance in-game. When you take this new rotation for a spin in-game, large aiming movements like turning around will probably feel strange at first, but you'll adapt to that very quickly. The key here isn't to just arbitrarily stick to a rotation because it drew the best lines. You'll want to be paying attention to how it feels when you're playing and to iterate from there if needed. And there we have it, an incredibly impactful variable we can adjust to help us achieve crisp and instinctive feeling aim. Let me know which rotation works best for you in the comments below. Subscribe for more content like this, and I'll catch you in the next one.